TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surbhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 23rd of January. No role for third-party mediation on Kashmir issue, says India's Foreign Ministry. Climate change due to deforestation worries people in Gilgit-Baltistan. And Afghan President Ghani urges Taliban to shun violence, says Afghans want peace. And now for all the details. Election fever has started gripping the Indian capital as it is set to go to polls on 8th of February. Delhi's Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal on Thursday held roadshows to campaign for his Aam Aadmi Party, which is set to lock horns with main contenders, Bharatiya Janata Party and the Congress.
Delhi Chief Minister and Aam Aadmi Party or AAP convener Arvind Kejriwal held roadshows in the national capital on Thursday to campaign for the upcoming Delhi Assembly polls. AAP won a record victory last time, capturing 67 of Delhi's 70 Assembly seats in 2014. Kejriwal expressed hope to get all 70 seats this time in face of the challenge from main contenders Bharatiya Janata Party and the Congress Party. In an interview, Kejriwal said he considers his government's work to improve Delhi's education and health system in last 5 years as its core strengths.
पिछली बार जब लोगों ने वोट दिया था, तो हमारे आंदोलन को देख के दिया था। उन्होंने देखा था कि ये यंग लड़के हैं, ईमानदार लड़के हैं, डरते नहीं हैं किसी से, कट्टर देशभक्त हैं, तो इनको एक मौका देना चाहिए। इस बार लोगों ने हमारा 5 साल का काम देखा है। इस बार हमारी परफॉर्मेंस के ऊपर वोट दे रहे हैं लोग।
The assembly elections in Delhi will be held on February 8 and the counting of votes will be held on February 11.
India reiterated on Thursday that there is no role for any third party in the Kashmir issue, rejecting US President Donald Trump's offer to mediate. The Indian government said the onus remains on Pakistan to create conducive conditions so that the talks can take place.
India's Foreign Ministry spokesperson Ravish Kumar on Thursday reiterated that there is no role for any third-party mediation on the Kashmir issue. He said that the onus lies on Pakistan to create a conducive environment for talks. This came in response to US President Donald Trump's latest offer for mediation on the Kashmir issue between India and Pakistan during a meeting with Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan on the sidelines of the World Economic Forum in Davos earlier this week. Trump said US was very closely watching developments over Kashmir and was prepared to help if necessary, but did not say how.
That there is no role for any third party in this matter. If at all there are any bilateral issues between India and Pakistan that needs to be discussed, it should be done between the two countries under the provisions of Shimla Agreement and Lahore Declaration. But again, as we have said in the past, that the onus is on Pakistan to create such conducive conditions.
Bilateral ties between India and Pakistan have remained strained since the Indian government revoked its Jammu and Kashmir special status and bifurcated it into two union territories in August last year. Kumar said, if Pakistan wants peaceful relations with India, it needs to take concrete actions against terrorism on its soil.
Moving on, months after suspending trade ties with India, Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan has said, when relations with India normalize, the world will recognize Pakistan's strategic economic potential.
Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan on Wednesday said the world will realize the true strategic economic potential of his country, where the relationship with India becomes normal. Khan, in his address at the World Economic Forum 2020 in Davos, said, unfortunately, the relations with India have not been great, but when they normalize and the trade between the two countries start, then one can imagine Pakistan's strategic economic potential. He further added his vision is to make Pakistan a welfare state and asserted that economic growth is not possible without peace and stability.
The moment Pakistan and Indian relationship becomes normal, trade starts between the two countries, then one can imagine the location, the strategic location of Pakistan with China on one side, India on one side, and then countries with excess energy on the western side.
This comes months after Pakistan suspended its trade relations with India in reaction to New Delhi's decision to revoke special status granted to its Jammu and Kashmir region. Tensions between the two arch rivals had also increased last year after Pulwama terror attack in Jammu and Kashmir, where 40 Indian security personnel were killed in a suicide blast. India had then alleged that the terror attack was perpetrated from Pakistan, but Islamabad denied the charges.
Locals in Gilgit-Baltistan have claimed that they are facing the effects of climate change caused due to the environmental degradation and large-scale deforestation in the illegally occupied region. They blame that exploitation of natural resources by Pakistan and China has affected the ecology in the region. The exploitation of natural resources by China and Pakistan that has affected the ecology and demography in Gilgit-Baltistan remains a major concern for the local residents of the region. Extensive snowfall or floods caused due to the melting glaciers in the region is symbolic of the climate change that has affected the region, which is under Pakistan's illegal occupation. Locals blame the ill effects of environmental degradation and large-scale deforestation due to so-called development projects have started showing up their effects.
اثرات ہے گلگت بلتستان کی حکومت صوبائی حکومت ہو یا وفاقی حکومت اس جانب توجہ دینے سے قاصر ہے آج تک کوئی یہاں پہ ریسرچ نہیں ہوئی ہے جس کی وجہ سے بہت سارے ایشوز ہیں یہاں پہ ڈیفورسٹریشن ایک سب سے مین وجہ جو ماحولیاتی تبدیلی کا سب سے مین وجہ ڈیفورسٹریشن ہے یہاں پہ درختوں کی بیجا کٹائی جاری ہے اگر میں گزر کی بات کروں تو یہاں ایک سال میں 170,000 سے زیادہ درخت کاٹے جا رہے ہیں ایندھن کے حصول کے لیے تو یہ بہت ہی بڑا ایشو ہے جس کے اوپر کام کرنے کی ضرورت ہے.
Despite being a land of natural resources, indigenous people of Gilgit-Baltistan are forced to live in poverty. It remains one of the poorest regions in Asia, with around 85% of the population striving to live on subsistence agriculture. The locals also have no access to basic amenities such as cooking gas, and majority of them are dependent on wood from forests. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani has said that his government is ready to reintegrate the Taliban only if they are ready to shun violence rather than seeking to overthrow the system and the society.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani on Wednesday said his government is ready to reintegrate the Taliban only if they are ready to shun violence rather than seeking to overthrow the system and the society. Speaking at a panel discussion on the sidelines of the World Economic Forum in Davos, he said the Afghan society has seen 40 years of violence, and to see the end of violence now depends very much on the Taliban to end the violence. Ghani also defended his legacy of the past 5 years, saying the country made significant achievements in various fields, including security and counter-terrorism.
Are the Taliban sufficiently aware to engage in this? Their power is negative, meaning it derives from violence, from suicide bombing, from violence against... But it's a negative power that is recognized by our society. And therefore, we want to see an end to it. For that, we have to find a political solution. All wars must end politically.
Ghani, on the sidelines of the event, met a number of world leaders, including US President Donald Trump. Both the leaders talked about the situation in Afghanistan, peace and regional security. This comes as reconvened peace talks between the US and the Taliban are underway. The Taliban has proposed a temporary ceasefire to pave the way for signing of peace deal with the US. However, Ghani-led Afghan government regard it as ambiguous, as it does not clearly call for a comprehensive ceasefire.
In news from Nepal, Nepal on Thursday voted to elect 18 members of the National Assembly, the upper house of the parliament. The two-year tenure of 19 lawmakers of the 59-member National Assembly will expire on 3rd of March, while one seat will be filled by presidential appointment.
Voting to elect 18 members of Nepal National Assembly, the upper house of parliament, was held across the Himalayan nation on Thursday. Provincial assembly members, chairpersons and deputy chairpersons in capital Kathmandu were seen casting their votes. The polling in all seven provinces began at 10 a.m. and continued till 4 p.m. local time. According to Election Commission of Nepal, a total of 2,056 voters, including 550 members from seven provincial assemblies and 1,506 representatives from local bodies, were eligible to cast their votes. A total of 45 candidates from six political parties, including ruling Nepal Communist Party and main opposition Nepali Congress, are in the fray. The two-year tenure of 19 lawmakers of 59-member National Assembly will expire on 3rd of March. One seat will be filled by the presidential appointment on recommendation of the government. The counting of votes and results of the poll are expected to be declared on the same day.
Indian Space Agency ISRO on Wednesday unveiled a humanoid robot, Vyom Mitra, meaning Friends of the Sky, which will travel to space on test flights of the Gaganyaan mission, the country's first manned mission to space. The Indian Space Research Organization, or ISRO, on Wednesday unveiled a humanoid astronaut's prototype that will travel to space on a test flight for Gaganyaan, the country's first manned mission to space. The humanoid, dubbed as Vyom Mitra, or a Friend of the Skies, is designed in such a way that it can talk and perform all functions of a crew. It is also expected to report to ISRO from space with collected data to further analysis in order to perfect the human flight. ISRO Chief K. Sivan said, four astronauts selected for Gaganyaan would go for training in Russia later this month.
This is the first prototype of the half-humanoid, which is scheduled to fly in the first unmanned Gaganyaan flight. So this primary objective is to mimic crew activity. So you can see in this poster, it can attain launch and orbital postures.
ISRO plans to send Vyom Mitra to space later this year, when it will launch unmanned flights to space as part of the Gaganyaan project. A youth in Srinagar city of India, Jammu and Kashmir, has made the best use of snowfall by making a snow car sculpture. His creation has become a sightseeing spot for many locals.
A youth in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir has tried to make the best use of snowfall in his region by creating a car model out of snow, inspiring many. Zubair Ahmed, who is in a business of car accessories, said he has been creating snow sculptures since his childhood and claimed he can build anything using snow. The fine detailing of the snow car is attracting the local residents of Srinagar city, who were seen clicking pictures with the model recently.
पहली बात है कि मैं से वाकिफ हूं बचपन से ही मैं ये करता हूं बचपन से ही मेरा शौक है ये और दूसरा कि मैं कार एक्सेसरीज का बिजनेस करता हूं अब इसलिए मैंने कार ही चूज की वरना मैं कुछ भी बना सकता हूं जो भी कुछ बोल कोई बोलेगा ना कुछ भी बनाओ मैं बनाने के लिए तैयार हूं
जो हमें ये यहां पे स्नो कार देखने को मिला हमें बहुत ही अच्छा लगा है और जो यूथ हैं ये मोटिवेट हुए हैं टुवर्ड्स स्नो स्कल्पचर और ये जुबैर से बहुत सीखना चाहते हैं और इन्होंने जुबैर को इंसिस्ट किया कि हमें सिखाए ये स्नो स्कल्पचर
India's Jammu and Kashmir region is witnessing a 40-day long period of extreme cold called Chillai Kalan, which usually begins from December end and continues till January end every year. During Chillai Kalan, the chances of snowfall are the highest and the maximum temperature drops considerably.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all Internet's edition. We will see you tomorrow. Good night.